There's still one more competitor that's on their way, and they'll be here any minute.
Oh man, you don't matter.
I'm Daniel Silva, and for those of you new here, I'm a tattoo artist in Los Angeles, California, and today is story time. This is gonna be my first ever story time, and it's gonna be all about my experience on Ink Master Angels. And I do appreciate everyone who has subscribed and has been commenting and viewing it really helps, but obviously there's 90% of you who are not subscribed, so I'd be very grateful if you can go down, press the subscribe button. It's not a big deal, but give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, let me know what's good, and it actually really helps with the algorithm, so thank you guys so much. It's kind of funny that it was one of my biggest times of like first blowing up, and I've never really talked about it online because I've done so much in between that time before I even started YouTube. It just kind of wasn't relevant. But just seeing all the questions you guys have sent me, I just decided that I should probably answer all these questions. So just a little backstory of how I actually got onto Ink Master. It was about 2-3 years ago is when I first did it. They DM'd me and I responded, and they made me fill out all this paperwork and told me that I could be on Ink Master Angels, which is a spin-off show that you actually have to win your spot onto the actual season, which was kind of annoying because then I went on to Ink Master and there was people that didn't have to do that were just on it, which was kind of annoying, but it was whatever. I was just like, oh, a TV show, I'm down to do it. I was not only the youngest on that episode, but the youngest on the whole entire season, the least experienced ever to be on Ink Master with only like 2 years of experience. And I was nervous. Like, I was so nervous. Never been on TV, never really did any kind of social media. Obviously, I'm not the type to really like film myself talking and post it on my Instagram. Like, I've never been around people that were doing that, so it wasn't really something that I did. So I wasn't like, never really been on camera in general. But they basically like brought us to San Francisco. They didn't really tell me anything. They didn't tell me who I was going up against. They didn't tell me what shop I was gonna go in. They didn't tell me really what I was gonna do. They basically were like, you're gonna come this day. Just make sure that you actually have to have a design ready that was gonna take you 4 hours, and it was gonna be on the neck. And obviously when you say like, hey, you're gonna get a neck tattoo, you obviously assume that it's gonna be on the side of your neck. All the paperwork's done, I know it's 100% that I'm gonna go, so what do? I need to make sure that I could do this tattoo in 4 hours. So immediately hit up one of my friends that I practiced on when I first started. I was like, hey, you want a free tattoo? I need to practice this, which they did not say was not part of the rules. So I actually designed this tattoo that was gonna be on the side of the neck, because that's what they said, neck. And I remember even responding to them and being like, can we do the back of the neck or anything like that? They're like, oh, it's a neck tattoo. And I'm like, okay, so obviously the side of the neck. Did it on his arm, did it in like 3 hours, and I was like, okay, the neck is gonna take even longer, so I was like, this is perfect. But it was super detailed, I knew it was still risky, but I was like, I'm trying to win. You know, high risk, high reward. Now when I actually went there, they keep you in a coffee shop. They kept us all in these coffee shops separately, and I sat there for about 5 hours before they even got onto the set, and basically didn't tell me nothing except, hey, you're gonna walk in, meet everybody, and you need to say like a zinger line or like a one-liner. And I'm like, okay, like what should I say? And they're like kind of like telling you this or that or this, but it just all sounds so corny. And it's like, it basically gave me 5 hours to figure out a one-liner when I'm gonna walk in and be like, hey guys, I don't even know what I was gonna say. And they ended up being like, oh, you're gonna be the first one to walk in. And I was so nervous, and I'm like, I was so like mad at the lady that was like talking to me, like, what the hell? Like, what am I gonna do? Like, why is this the process? Cause I'm so nervous and I don't know what I'm gonna say. They ended up being like, oh, we think you're gonna bomb, so we're gonna put you in last. And the people that are your competitors are gonna just like say shit to you, I guess. I was like, well, whatever, I don't give a shit. And so I'm just so nervous, and finally they just walk you down the street. So I open the door, I walk in, and immediately I just see Ryan Ashley, Kelly Doty, and Nikki Simpson just sitting there. And I look to my left, and there's just two random guys. And don't really know where I'm at. And immediately these dudes just start like talking shit to me.
You in the wrong spot, bro. I think the yacht club, or whatever. What.
Which is actually hilarious, which they got so much shit for. But basically they're just talking shit, being like, oh, look at this pretty boy, welcome to the yacht club or something, because they kind of made me wear like a collar shirt. They kind of wanted me to be like this like clean looking pretty boy. So they actually decided that I was gonna wear a collared shirt. I was like, dude, let me just wear a black hoodie, what's good? But super funny. I'm like literally shaking, like my legs, like I could not stand still. Like my leg was just shaking. It was so intense. And I definitely choked. So I'm glad I didn't go in first because it was insane. I remember I said something like, oh, like they're like, why'd you get into tattooing? I was like, oh, like
definitely knew I wasn't gonna get a real job.
Ryan Astley immediately responds.
So you don't think tattooing is a real job?
I'm like, oh my God, what the heck is this? And I remember I got a bunch of shit for that, which is actually so funny. But after that, I think it kind of broke up and they're kind of showing us our stations and kind of like revealing of where I'm at and what is actually happening. So I'm in Ed Hardy's shop going against Ed Hardy's son, who's been tattooing for 20 years. And then this other guy named Funk, who's been tattooing for like 10 years. And I'm like this young ass kid, only been tattooing for 2 years. So immediately I'm like terrified. I'm like, this legendary son of Ed Hardy has been taught by Ed Hardy for 20 years. It's insane. After they kind of show us the spots and figure it out, they're like, okay. They kind of tell us a little bit more about the rules to kind of like put us on the line. And they're like, okay, so this tattoo is going to be on the back of the neck. It has to be on the back of the neck. And immediately I'm like, what are you talking about? I asked if it could be on the back of the neck. You did not specify that it's supposed to be on the back of the neck. You said neck, and I assumed it was gonna be on the side. The other two people knew for a fact it was gonna be on the back of the neck, is why they both ended up with perfectly symmetrical pieces that were gonna look super dope on the back of the neck. And they were like, no, we told you too. I'm like, dude, look at these messages. I even tried to clarify with you and you just basically told me the side of the neck. And I was so mad, and at that point I was like, dude, I'm effed. Like, and they're like, oh, we'll give you 15 minutes to go in the car and redesign your shit. And I'm like, okay. I get in the thing, get my iPad out, and I'm just sitting there like low-key, I was just shaking. I'm like freaking out. What am I gonna design? I started like trying to draw something, I'm shaking. I'm like, you know what? F this. I'm just gonna do my design on the back of the neck. If I lose, I lose. And I ended up going into the spots, the canvas comes in. I got like this really hot girl at first and everything was good to go. We were about to start, like they're about to count down. And the lady goes like, hold on, I need to do something. She walks out, tells the producer she's out. She doesn't want to do it. My canvas just walks out right when it's about to start. So that obviously like freaked me out. They ended up going across the street, getting some guy out of a bar, being like, hey, do you want to get tattooed on Ink Masters across the street right now? And he was like, yeah, he's down. And he basically came over and he has only traditional tattoos and I'm not a traditional tattoo artist. And he immediately goes into this spot where he doesn't know shit. So he thinks like, this is my tattoo area, which is all traditional, everything around it. And like my design was like my design. Like that's that, you're not gonna get nothing else. Like you don't have time to draw anything else. And he's like, oh, what if we do that instead or this instead? I'm like, dude, we're doing this. Like this is what you signed up for. And he's like, oh, okay. He's like, do you think we do color in it? I'm like, honestly, we're not gonna have time for color. You can put color in it later. And obviously, that was a dead lie. I'm like sweating. I'm in this like weird area. Like the area that I'm set up is set up for a left-handed tattooer. So I immediately have to move everything and nothing's working. So I had to stand up this whole entire time, like leaned over, stood up. This guy's just on some random chair, pulled back, kind of straddling it. And it's the most uncomfortable tattooing position I've ever been in. Not only that, it was so hot that day, I'm literally like sweating, like dripping down my sweat. Like literally, I was like, dude, like my client's gonna literally black out. Go get a fan, put a fan on it. So while I'm tattooing, midway through, they get a fan and they start blowing on us and I'm standing up and sweating. It was just the most intense thing ever. And after that, I basically walked out, saw the other two tattoos and immediately were like, holy shit, your boy just crushed it. Holy shit, like it literally looked like it wasn't my best work ever by far, but it was literally like, I knew for a fact I won. So we basically, I started feeling real good about it. I started loosening it up, feeling real good. And I went to like the little judging line or whatever. And obviously we're supposed to like talk shit about each other's tattoos. I don't really remember what words were said, but immediately they were like, Daniel wins with a unanimous decision. They all chose that I was the best one. So then they chose that Funk was the worst one. So then he went home and now it's me versus Ed Hardy's son. And like, obviously I saw his work already. I thought it was gonna be a lot better, but it just wasn't there. And it was kind of unfortunate for him because what they chose next was like fine line jewelry tattoos, which was kind of like Ryan Astley's specialty at the time and still is. But like I did a lot of that type of stuff too. So immediately I was just like, went home to draw it and the tattoo was gonna be the next day.
and we had a little bit more time to do this one, and it was on a leg. Since I won, I got to choose what client I wanted, so I kind of like finessed that as well. So I had a little advantage, and the style of tattooing was a little bit more of my style. So when I sit down to draw it at that night, I wasn't like, oh, what am I gonna draw to win? I was just like, what am I gonna draw to like flex on Ryan Ashley, because I'm coming after her. So obviously tattoo went great. I won unanimously again. And now they give you a decision on which Ink Master Angel you want to go up against. And me personally, Kelly Doty's amazing at color. Nikki Simpson's awesome as well. But Ryan Ashley was like the belt holder. She won Ink Master. She was like their pride and joy, like the best person, right? So I wanted to go after her. And I remember it was very odd because at the very beginning when they're doing the phone consultation, I was like, who are you gonna go up against if you win? And I was like, Ryan Ashley, Ryan Ashley. And right when they're asking me, they're trying to like convince me otherwise, because I think they didn't really want me to lose because they wanted me on the show. But I was like, dude, Ryan Ashley, I want Ryan Ashley. I want the host of the show, I want the Ink Master. Like, I wanna go after her. And basically, they were trying to convince me out of it, but finally I was like, boom, I'm doing it. Like, I don't know what you want from me. I'm not gonna think more. But we ended up picking these skulls. I ended up getting like a really, really great, super cool canvas. And that night I just couldn't sleep. I was just drawing this tattoo and sat down with my client, and she was just really willing to let me do whatever I wanted. So I was just like spending all night just drawing like this design. I was like, holy shit, I need to win this. Now the design is done, it's a wolf growling with like a scenery and a crown and like mandala stuff. Like, I was like super stoked on this design. I'm pretty sure I've even like remastered that design later on in my career. But I remember when I was doing it, I was like, it was crazy because we walked into this scene. On this challenge in particular that was against Ryan Ashley versus me, there was three votes. One of those votes are the two people I just beat. So I was like, what the hell? Why would they pick me? Like, does it make sense? Like, I just beat them and talk shit to them. And then the other one is a live crowd, which are gonna be watching us during the whole entire tattoo. And they're all gonna put votes in Ryan Ashley's and mine. And basically they'll tally up those votes and that will be another vote. And then the third one is the other two angels that aren't tattooing. So I was like, wow, their best friends are gonna be the one deciding if I win or lose. That's annoying. And the crowd, I'm like, dude, Ryan Ashley, this crowd is here for Ink Masters. Ryan Ashley is like their golden child. Like, everyone loves that girl. So I was like, this is not gonna go well. So basically start doing the tattoo. I totally even forgot like my iPad, forgot everything. I just didn't have any reference photo or nothing. So I had to do a full realistic wolf scenery and everything with no reference photo. Just sat there and looked at it and just hoped for the best that I remembered what I was gonna tattoo. And boom, the tattoo is done. And I'm like, dude, I'm feeling really good about this.
Daniel is really killing it. He has detailed the hell out of that thing. What I wish to see in Ryan's tattoo, which is all that nice detail that she's known for, is showing up in Daniel's tattoo.
I'm thinking Ryan is in trouble.
I feel like Ryan is in trouble too.
Not only did I beat Ryan Ashley, but I was the only one to ever beat Ryan Ashley and the only one to win a whole episode unanimously. That means all three votes went to me each time. So at the very end, which was more risky of what the votes were gonna be, Kelly and Nikki voted for me, the whole entire crowd, majority voted for me, and even the two people I just beat and just talked shit to voted for me as well. So I was like, dude, that is insane. Like, your boy is on to the next level. And it was really dope because I was kind of going into the next season as the underdog, the young tattooer, just beat their like golden child. So it was really cool to like see the fan base kind of like get my back during the whole entire season. But all in all, one of the craziest experiences of my life. I don't think tattooing should be in that form where it's like rushing and, you know what I mean? Like, I'm kind of a tattoo artist that really wants the art to be the best. I wanna focus and make sure each client gets what they deserve. And in that setting, it didn't seem that I could really do that because there was a whole nother motive, which was just kind of like winning and kind of doing stuff that was more for me. So I wouldn't really recommend like clients like getting tattoos in that way. It's probably super cool for the person to be on TV, but to me, I just think art needs to be a lot more like time spent on it. But yeah, insane. So that is my story of going from this kid in a small town to being DM'd by Ink Master, getting on the show, beating Ryan Ashley, beating Ed Hardy's son, being the youngest one, the least experienced ever to be on Ink Master, and just overall crushing that episode, besides the fact that my hair looked like shit and I was wearing a collar. And I was really nervous, and it was the first time ever you like hear your voice online, so it's kind of like, what the heck is this? This is how I sound? That's crazy. But all in all, great experience. Would I do it again? I would do Ink Master because there's actually a prize. All in all, thank you guys so much for listening. A lot of you have been asking me so much about this for so long. And if you guys like the video, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below if there's other story times that you want me to do. In the next story time, I will tell you my experience on Ink Master season 10. But please go and subscribe and definitely go check out my Instagram where I post most of my work. Until then, see you next time.